Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
Thank you. sa pinakilatan.
Ayun. Ang makalitot siya.
May tumatukol din.
es bien. This one is Mass deceased. If you leave on Mass in the St. Michael prayer, if anybody has any religious struggles, they want to bless them. Happy blessings for you. Following that, if anybody would still like to go to confession, confessions will be available in the main church until the line ends. We will expose the Blessed Sacrament also immediately following Mass in the main church, and the Blessed Sacrament will be exposed until 3 p.m. Thanks for being here. Thank you. At the name of Jesus, every knee should bend, of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit,
amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
Amen. With your spirit.
Brethren, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the Savior. I confess
to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me.
Forgive us our sins and bring us to everlasting life.
Kyrie
eleison.
Whose strength you are, their hearts are set on the pilgrimage. As we go in the Philippines, Viva la Virgen!
Viva la Virgen!
Viva il Divino Rostro!
Viva il Divino Rostro!
Thank you very much. So my dear sisters and brothers, my sermon this morning will consist of two parts. The first part is about the history of the devotion of the Divino Rostro. The history of the Francia, you will know it tomorrow. And the second part is about the theme for this year's celebration. The theme for this year's celebration in the Philippines for Divino Rostro is that the Divino Rostro brings harmony and unity and the spirit of dialogue and respect. During the years 1834, 1853, and 1955, a cholera epidemic called cholera moro struck the whole country of Spain. All nearby towns suffered from the cruel effects of the dreadful malady. The natives of Osa de la Vega prayed and made devotions to the Holy Face to protect them from the epidemic. After the cholera epidemic had passed, to the surprise of many, no one in the village died or was stricken by the cholera. This made the faith of the people and their devotion to the Divino Rostro grow much, much stronger. This also began the spread of devotion to other parts of the country. In 1882, a cholera similar to one in Spain in 1834 broke out in Manila, Philippines. The vicar general at the time of the diocese, now Archdiocese of Nueva Casales, was a certain priest, Reverend Father Pedro de la Torre, who was a native of Osa de la Vega, Spain, and a devotee of the Divino Rostro. He had with him a copy of the divine Divino Rostro being venerated in his hometown. Recalling that what happened in Spain, he requested the Bishop of Nueva Casales then, Bishop Guerrero, to enshrine the holy picture at the Cathedral of their diocese, where the people could venerate for the whole duration of the epidemic. People flocked to the church and imploring divine intervention that spared from the deadly cholera. And the bishop also ordered that the intercession of the Lady of Peña Francia be sought. On August 26, 1882, the image of Our Lady of Peña Francia was brought to the Cathedral of Manila. That was the first time that the Bicolanos prayed to the Lady of the Peña Francia and the Divino Rostro together in one place. That was also the beginning of the tradition that continues up to the present. When during the Transmission procession, both images are borne to the cathedral. When the dreaded disease was dispelled, our people were spared from it, like what had happened in Spain. And thanksgiving, the hierarchy of the church and the people promised to celebrate the feast of the Divino Rostro and Our Lady of Peña Francia together. And so when the image of Ina was brought back to her shrine in that same year, the image of the Divino Rostro was also brought together with the former shrine at the Basilica Minore of Our Lady of Peña Francia. If there is an international devotion to Son always go together. So when God became man, in the person of Jesus Christ, he assumed a human face. Because of Christ's incarnation, we can now behold the face of God and the face of his Son, Jesus. He manifests his face, his true self, for no other reason than for the love he has for us. If Jesus loves us, the question is, do we love him in return? Do you love others as Jesus loves us? Can we say that love reigns in the families, in the communities, or in the whole world? Perhaps you know the answer. I wish that as we reflect the theme of our celebration today, the Divino Rostro brings harmony and unity in the spirit of dialogue and respect. Remind us once again of the great love shown in the holy face of Jesus. As the Church undertakes its evangelizing mission, the spirit of dialogue manifested as an attitude of respect and of friendship that should permeate all those activities constituting the evangelizing mission of the Church. The incarnation of our Lord Jesus is ultimately an image, an example of dialogue, like what the Lions of Green Bay is doing on our journey of discipleship. God becoming man, sharing our human life, and speaking in a human language to bring the goodness, is an example of deep solidarity that moves the Church dialogue with peoples, cultures, and religion. Throughout history, there has been found among indigenous peoples a certain awareness of a hidden power, which lies behind the course of nature and the events of human life. At times, there is present the latent recognition of supreme being. This awareness and recognition results in a way of life that is imbued with a deep religious sense. My dear sisters and brothers, the divine face of Jesus in front of us orders the faithful again to enter with prudence and charity in the discussions and collaborations with people and other religions, colors and cultures. Let us, as Christians, while witnessing of their own faith and way of life, must acknowledge, preserve, and encourage the spiritual and moral truth found among people of other faith, tradition, color, and also social life. The ultimate purpose of dialogue is for the whole humanity to live in harmony and fraternal love. This fraternal love will ensure peace in our land, which seems to be elusive in reality. This call of our celebration today, to live in harmony, asks us to love one another concretely. It calls us to respect its other with all our differences, to love our neighbor as ourselves, and to protect the rights and freedoms of all humanity. As we also being asked to practice human fraternity by embracing all human beings and trying to be united and treating each one with respect, this requires preserving and protecting its other, the freedom, and that is a right of every person, where its individual enjoy the freedom of belief, thought, expression, and action. fraternal love, also asks us to walk together in building a better world through preserving the name of justice and mercy. The foundations of prosperity and the cornerstone of faith, we have to love. And this means having the firm conviction that the authentic teachings of religious invite us to remain rooted always in the value of peace. It also asks us to always be ready to ask forgiveness for the wrong that we have said, done and thought of others, and to be ready to forgive others for the wrong that they have done to us. While we are facing this invisible enemy, the COVID-19 virus, may this be a season of trust, hope, and love to keep us strong in faith and courageous enough to face the many challenges we encounter in life. We should never tire in striving to conserve and defend values of mutual understanding, human fraternity, and harmonious coexistence, guided by the loving gaze of the holy face of Jesus. According to Pope Emeritus Benedict, the true reverence for the face of Christ means three things. First, that we recognize his wounded face in the faces of our wounded brothers and sisters, those individuals on the margin of society who are the victims of violence and war and racism, those who are homeless, those who are mentally and physically ill, those who are suffering greatly at the present time. We consciously choose not to turn our gaze from them. Second, we reverence the face of Christ, and Paul Benedict added, by contemplating the passion of Jesus. Third, that we reverence the face of Christ by recognizing his real presence in the Holy Eucharist and adoring him in the sacrament of the altar. This call of Pope Emeritus Benedict is a powerful affirmation to the call of the Diocese of Green Bay under the leadership of our very fatherly Bishop David Wigan. For us now, to go back to church in order to worship the Lord as a community, in order to be healed and strengthened by the Eucharist. And once again, gaze the face of the holy face in the altar of the Eucharist. Viva el Divino Rostro!
Viva el Divino Rostro!
Let us turn to our Heavenly Father for our petitions.
For the conversion of the world from malice, violence, injustice, unchastity, disbelief, arrogance, deceit, and disregard for the sanctity of human life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
That husbands and wives will grow in their love for each other and be shining witnesses of Christ's love for their families and everyone in their lives. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Pope Francis' that the planet's resources will not be plundered, but shared in a just and respectful manner. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For Bishop Wickham's monthly intention, that our Catholic schools truly be schools of discipleship, where our young, our youth can grow in their friendship with Jesus Christ. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all personal prayer petitions entrusted to our daily good help here at your shrine, that those petitions will be answered according to God's holy and wonderful providence. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
And thanksgiving for the living and deceased benefactors of this shrine, and that more benefactors will come forward to further the message and mission of the shrine of our Lady of Good God. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Heavenly Father, we ask that you can hear these prayers and answer them freely in accord with your most holy will, through Christ our Lord.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, the fruit of the earth and work of human hands, will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed are you, Lord God, of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine and all of you. For your wine and work of human hands will become our spiritual food.
Blessed be God. The Lord be with you.
Lift
up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. His death we celebrate in love, his resurrection we confess with living faith, and his coming in glory we await with unwavering hope. And so with all the angels and saints, we praise you, as without end, we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, Venis Nocemi et Terra, Gloria Tua, Hosanna in excelsis. Thank you.
accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant your peace to guard your life and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and David, our Bishop, and all those who hold into the truth and non-Catholic and apostolic faith. Therefore, Lord, we pray, gracious, to accept this oblation of our service, that your whole family order our days in your peace, and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation, and counted among the flock of those who have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve your doctrine in every respect, making it spiritual and acceptable, so that they become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, he took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." given us, this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the Just, the sacrifice of Abraham our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer we ask you, Almighty God, command these gifts to be borne by the hands of your holy angels, the altar on high and center of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation in the altar receive the most holy body of our dear Son, may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Remember also, Lord, our sermons. Who have gone before us with a sign of faith and rest in the sleep of peace. Grant them, O Lord, we pray, and all who sleep in Christ, a place of refreshment, light, and peace.
Bless also your servants, good of sinners, hope in your abundant mercies. Graciously grant some share and fellowship with your holy apostles and martyrs. With John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, in your company, not weighing our merits, but granting us your pardon, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Prove that he continues to make all these good things, O Lord, be sanctified and filled with light, bless them, and bestow them upon us.
Through him, with him, and in him, O God, mighty Father, in unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant your peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
On your day, we call this day
Amen.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, my soul shall be healed.
Grant us in your mercy, O Lord, we pray that in these sacred mysteries we may do worthy homage to the Lord Jesus. For it is your will that at his name every knee should bend, and in him all people find salvation, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Before anything else, I wanted to thank Father, especially for his homily today, but also all fathers for being here, for the Father of you all. Last night I read the devotion, the dual devotion, which I think was an excellent point, dual devotion of Nuestra Niña Francia? Okay, correct me later. I'll get it down eventually. And Divino Rostro. And what struck me immediately, which you mentioned in your homily, was the small village initially. There were three years where there was the pandemic broke out. And what struck me immediately was, okay, I knew you guys were going to be coming in today, and I thought, this is the perfect place here in the United States. You know, years ago, the beginning of the devotion here, among other things, was of course Our Lady appearing, but also the famous Peshtigo Fire. Remember Peshtigo, so you know all about this. The Peshtigo Fire came through, and this place was miraculously saved, as were people who fled here. Fled to Our Lady and fled to Jesus here at the shrine. So I think that this is a good matchup. So I hope you guys will be with us in the future years. For anybody who's watching live stream, we want to invite you in the future. This was just the first year we're hoping, and we want this to be an annual thing, and we're hoping that this can become bigger over time, and maybe we can get Father Jewel back. Father Jewel, I'd like to replace his parent, he and his brother are a priest in the community, and both of them have Filipino parents, so I'm the white person out here right now. But I think, Father, it'd be great if we could make this an annual event, and thank you, Father, for being here. The Lord be with you. St. Michael, the Archangel, defend us in battle, be our protection against the wickedness and snares of the devil. May God rebuke it beyond the grave, and do thou all things to heaven and angels. By the power of God, Christ and the blessed city, and all the angel spirits, who are all about the world, seeking the ruins of souls. Amen. As I mentioned before, Mass and religious articles, they want to bless, I'll be happy to bless those for you now. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. May our Lord Jesus Christ, through the intercession of Mary, his mother, and through the intercession of all his angels and saints, bless.